phones. Phones are revolutionary, but seeing the bigger picture, phones might hurt us more than help. Phones are taking control of students all over the world. Kids are hooked on social media and addictive apps. They pay more attention on their games and their phones than they should on their schoolwork. This problem is spreading rapidly. We need to protect the generation before us. We need to stop this right now.
If schools were able to monitor cell phone usage,
it may decrease bullying. Annie Graham was 13 when she killed herself. Her friends say she was picked on at school and on social media. Her death promoted about 50 students to walk out of school in an anti-bullying protest. At Lewiston Middle School, the school that Annie went to, wants to get to the root of cyberbullying, so they started a digital citizenship program, which should take twice a week during homeroom. During digital citizenship program, they learned how to engage safely and appropriately online. And on top of that, they also banned cell phones. Having the school monitor the cell phones could have saved Annie's life and improved her school life too.
After just 3 months at attending an anonymous high school undercover, the 22-year-old Linda was being talked about in several group chats sexually. Remember, this person was 22 and on a reality TV show. They uncovered multiple things that people did behind backs of students and teachers on cell phones. This is why we need to stop the cell phone usage in schools.
If schools or parents were able to monitor their kids' cell phone usage, and the kids may be persuaded to get off their phone more often. If kids got off their phone more often, it would reduce more stress, anxiety, and suicide. Dr. Nancy Cleveland warned you that cell phones will impact your health. About 73% of people say that phones are their reason for stress. If you were able to put your phone down more often, you would have more time to study instead of cramming everything into 5 minutes. You would get better grades, and let's be honest, cell phones are super distracting.
Schools are trying to take away how students express themselves, students facing reality, and their privacy. Schools should not monitor social media because they have the right of privacy. In and outside of school, they would need to take action and would be taking away how they express themselves. Students also have rights they wish to be followed. Our first argument is maintaining privacy on social media is greatly important. Students should be able to have the right of privacy while on social media. According to How to Maintain Your Privacy Online, Betsy Kemper stated, when it comes to social media, people tend to overlook the importance of maintaining their privacy. Students should be able to feel protected when on social media, but they can't if someone is watching everything they do online. Betsy argues the single most important thing you can do to stay safe online is to keep your personal information to yourself. They should feel trusted, not violated, by their own education provider when on social media. According to the Right to Privacy, Allison Moretta explained, they were powerless to stop the invasions of privacy. Students should not feel powerless when schools check their social media. Therefore, schools should not be looking at students' social media.
Our second argument is, not only should students have the right to privacy, but they should also be allowed to take matters into their own hands. And so should their parents. The United States Department of Health and Human Services states, always think about what you post. You never know what someone will report. Being kind to others online will help to keep you safe. Do not share anything that could hurt or embarrass anyone. Students can oftentimes do these things to themselves, and they and their parents should be able to take control of it. Since students can take matters into their own hands, when schools threaten to check their social media apps, most are better at controlling their privacy settings than others. It would be completely useless to them to check their social media. Schools are sacrificing privacy and devoting unbelievable resources inefficiently. The same article states. Also, if schools were taking matters into their own hands, the cost would be about $14,000 for all of the monitoring systems, which might cause schools to, in the future, cut different programs and teachers, as it was reported that one school district is spending $14,000 annually on its social media monitoring program. It is costly for every district that does it. And our last argument is students will feel uncomfortable expressing themselves on social media when schools are monitoring them. One of the most important parts of being a teenager is finding yourself. With schools spying on your every move on social media, it can be uncomfortable for the students to create an outlook for themselves. The article, Social Media Can Be a Platform of Self-Expression, explains that research shows social media improves quality of life. It is so easy to get lost in the big world, especially as a teenager. With the use of social media, teenagers have an outlet to express themselves, which is important because expression is key during the teenage years. Not only does it teach students about themselves, but it gets them ready for other skills they might need in the future, such as communicating skills. Wilson also says, social media gives people value. It allows them to put their best self out there, brand their content, express themselves, and build relationships. Social media, put simply, is a social community. As young adults today, it is more important than ever to be a part of this community.
As my opponent may have said that cell phones help kids express themselves healthy, what if the students want to express themselves negatively or inappropriately? Inappropriately hurting others is where they go. That is not healthy. That is not healthy for young minds to perceive.
My opponent said that it would prevent bullying. This is not true because the bully would find other effective ways to bully the victim.
We need to reverse our ways. It's not what we do that counts. It's not what we say that counts, it's what we do. Save the generations before us. Don't let them go down the same path. We need to stop this problem immediately. Thank you.
In conclusion, our team has proven schools should not monitor social media. Students need to have the right to privacy when on social media.
Not only should students have the right to privacy, but they should also be allowed to take matters into their own hands, and so should their parents. Checking students' social media accounts will only make students fear that the school might be taking away the ability to express themselves. Let me ask you this. Would you want someone watching your every move?